Drop the bat. Work those hips. Raise your arms. Big box, little box, big box, little box. Back to swing and spot. Grab the bat. Hug the bat. Drop the bat. Kick the bat across the dance floor. Then I grab the bat again and suddenly find my arms filled by my dance partner. His arms wrapped around me like the steel bars of an impossible cage. Love is all you need. He whispers breathily in my ear and runs his tongue down the side of my neck to the base of my throat. The rasp of a flint he comes out of his back gets me to fire. Thank you. Margaret Thatcher assassination inquiry that doesn't officially exist. She shoots at him. And that's just you, Chief. Look, I'm pretty sure you aren't just coming out of the past of the incident. I set you up. Instantly, you're tall, 10 minutes up. Okay? I nod. She disappears, and I finish my vial coffee. The third mouthful stuns my taste buds enough to let the rest slip down without too much pain. I hope this isn't going to turn out to be a wild goose chase. 20 minutes later, a rapid-looking custody sergeant fetches me from the booth, where I have forced down a second bucket of suspect to the bottom of the front of the plastering himself across the glass wall upside down. He's right in front of us again, but in contact with the ceiling. folk. I do not get to leave the police station for some time. I am, as they say, unavoidably detained. Not as unavoidably as the late Mr. Spratt, who is pronounced dead at the scene by the on-call doctor. But DGI Sullivan isn't going to let me escape until she's taken me aside for a very free and frank exchange of opinions. Still, she demands, leaning on my face. I was testing the hypothesis. I hunch my shoulders. I feel dreadful, cold, in need of some safe space to retreat into while I get my head centered again. Michael Spratt? No. I ask them a fatal question. Did you hear about the Bank of England case? I ask more to distract myself than to inform Joe. What? The pen drops instantly. Okay. So they're locking the lid down tight on it. That makes this easier. Listen, Jack may not have been as out of it as your son thought. Well, he's going to be in the first room. Something with something. Thank you. I'm going to keep it as short as possible. On Monday, 9 o'clock in the morning, I have to be ready to walk into the Home Secretary's office and deliver a presentation articulating my goals, our strategic plan for achieving those goals, dealing with regulations on timely legislation we need in order to meet those goals in a local manner, our required budget, our roadmap for implementation, metrics for assessing our performance on an ongoing basis, and the new actions. I see eyes open. I also sometimes write good words, which are the thank you. Presentation loaded and ready at first sight. Check.